Hi, I'm Laura Sanchez. I'm your teacher for Sociology 6010. I'm really looking forward to meeting you, and I'm glad that you're part of our sociology program here at BGSU. I think you're going to find that you have scholars here that care about creating great research, preparing scholars for a variety of endeavors in both the public and private spheres. And that we have people who are working very hard on social justice issues. And so you're going to get an enormous amount of skills. You're going to get skills that are going to serve you well, and we're also going to work very hard at helping you hone what you'd like to do with your talents. But that's a side issue. I'm actually just sending you a short video to tell you two things that you need to know before we meet for the first time at the end of the first week when we meet on Friday for our Friday classes from 2:30 to 5:15. The first one is that we only have 14 times that we meet this semester. And so, usually we meet 16 times, but because of the way the holidays fell and the way they have our course scheduled, we only meet 14. So that means that I am wanting you to have readings done on the very first day when we meet. And so I have released and published our course on Canvas, and you'll be able to find the syllabus. And you'll see that if you go to the modules area for our class, I've organized the course into 14 weeks or 14 modules. And in each, you'll find the readings that you need, except for the books that you have to buy, of course. And that when you look in the module, you'll see that it starts out with a podcast. And so there's a brief, a very brief 3 to 8 minute podcast that tells you what I think is important about that week, what we'll be addressing. And then there's kind of a worksheet that tells you what kind of questions I hope you'll be able to answer after having done the readings, and then the readings. And each week is organized that way. And that you'll be expected to, before you show up for class, obviously have the readings done. And that to engage in discussion every week before class. Part of your course grade will be going into Canvas and going to the discussion board and posting some thoughts about the readings that we have for that week, like something that's really striking you of interest. And then maybe some questions about the readings. And that's just to kind of get people oriented about what you're thinking and to hear your first reactions. I know that's a lot to take in, and so that's why I'm letting you know with this video. If you have any questions or concerns about it, let me know, but I'll reach out to you via email in that first week before we meet just to remind you of what we're doing. So you have some readings in the very first week. They are mainly about the kind of the history of sociology and the history of sociological theory, and why it is that we always have to learn about Marx, Durkheim, and Weber, and about what sociology theory looks like now as we are bringing in all sorts of post-colonial theorists and theorists from around the world, and queer theorists and intersectionalist theorists, like how is sociology being transformed? So that's what this semester is going to be about. But the first week is thinking through why do we do it in a particular kind of way? And what is it to be a young person like yourself, young in the field, who's learning about the field? Like, why do we train you in a particular kind of style? And is it the best kind of style to meet the needs of our world's pressures right now? So anyway, you have readings for day one. The second really important thing I wanted to talk about or just tell you about is that none of us really know what's going to happen in the near future. We know that we're still facing the global pandemic, and I expect it to go on in different kinds of forms, mutations, for at least another year, if not a little bit more, if previous pandemics have been any measure. But in the short term, what we know for our own community is that the Delta variant has finally arrived in Wood County, that people are getting more and more vaccinated, though we're still at about 50%, and that it looks like the Delta variant is choosing different kinds of age groups than it did in the first sweep, or the Alpha version selected. So we have risks, and so I want you to know that I'm going to do the best of my ability to organize this course so that we together can manage the risks. And so I'm trying to figure out how I can build in redundancies in the course so that if you feel like you need to not come to class physically, you can still get the materials and share in conversation and dialogue. And there's a lot of reasons why you might not come, from feeling uncertain about know, just feeling uncertain, to having had an exposure, any number of things. Hopefully nothing will happen, but I want to make some sort of redundancies built in. And then the other thing is I want to figure out ways that will, you know, just kind of be comfortable with the course management. And so for the first week of classes, I'm going to send out a survey to you early in the week that asks you, would you like to meet in class in person for that first week before we talk about how we're going to organize the course? Would you like to meet via Zoom? Or would you like to meet, but not indoors? Like, could you like to meet on campus, except outdoors if the weather's good? And so I'll send you out a survey about that. It's obviously going to be a confidential survey because I know exactly the people I'm sending it to, but it'll be anonymized in the sense that I won't get the results knowing what you particularly chose. I'll just kind of know what the total class chose. So anyway, just give it some thought about that, how you'd like to kind of have a first discussion. In that first time that we meet, I want to talk to you about the substantive meaning of the course, but also ways in which we feel like we can be really good demographers and public health demiologists, epidemiologists and sociologists to figure out how we can meet in ways that will really challenge us and allow us to meet each other and become a community and share our ideas, but also maintain safety. So that's it. Those are the two things I've already talked on for 6 minutes. So I'll stop now. I'm really looking forward to meeting you. Feel free to email me with any concerns you have, or just even an email telling me a little bit about yourself. A little bit about myself. I'm a family sociologist and a feminist demographer. I have been the director of research centers, two research centers over my lifetime. So I really can kind of think about how to get research done, different ways of approaching things. And then for a personal side, I love gardening. I love reading. I love tarot cards, for whatever that's worth. And I love horses. I have two horses, so you probably hear more about that than you should. So I am really looking forward to hearing about you. You take care.